Good morning, everybody. It's Sarah, and it's Saturday, and I'm going to be just showing you a little bit about Giant Luna and how I have constructed her head in order to make her ears stand up a little bit better. So this video won't be all in one part, and I don't know how we'll share it, but we're all waiting with great anticipation for Giant Luna patterns to come in. This is the second time in the last few weeks that we've had a difficult situation with couriers and things not getting to us as we expected them to. So I'm really hoping that they arrive today. Some should be arriving today, like a duplicate order should be arriving today. Anthony and I are going to pack them tonight so that you get them on Monday morning. But thank you everybody for your orders. It's been a really busy week. We're still in the process of getting the acrylic templates out to everybody. So yeah, there's an awful lot going on, but thank you very much for your patronage and your patience as well. So let's, I don't have Giant Luna here as a thing. I've just got some body parts. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I construct the ear. So the ear, obviously you've got seam allowance on this. I think it's a 1 centimetre on your giant pattern. And you're going to construct in exactly the same way as you would for Luna's ear. Except that you might use heavy interfacing rather than medium. If you've only got medium to hand, you can always just apply 2 layers of medium, one fused, and then put another one on the back. What I found with mine was, because it's a much larger area, is that it has delaminated slightly. So just take care when you're applying the interface and putting the iron on, just smooth from one edge across to the other to make it as smooth a surface as possible. So I've turned my ear through. I've obviously trimmed my seam allowances off, turned my ear through, and you can see down here at the bottom, I've got various, you know, different levels of what's going on, but I'm going to work to the level of the felt as being my truest point. And you've got a 2 centimetre seam allowance at the bottom here. So the first thing I've done once I've pressed this out is I've pressed it flat. And then it might be that you want to do your sewing up through the middle, like we say in normal Luna instructions, just to hold those 2 layers together. Once I've pressed it flat, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use my plastic inserts. So you'll need a 4-pint, this is where it gets really Blue Peter, you'll need a 4-pint milk carton washed out, and I've given you in the pattern a template to cut yourself some plastic strips, and you'll need 4 of these. So I've got one that I found from when I was messing around with this last week, and you'll probably draw this out, but I'm nothing if not slapdash. So I'm just going to take a piece out. The milk bottles will differ and they will have different points where they curve and mold, but with any 4-pinter you should be able to get enough flat space out to give yourself 4 strips. So I'm just going to need 2 for this because I've done one of mine already, so just doing them roughly. So I've got one that I did earlier and one that I've done now. What you're going to need to do is allow about 4 centimetres to drop below the line of stitching. And I'm just going to pass these. Obviously, your interfacing is fused to your Liberty. This is Michelle in, I think, Blues and Aquas, is it? And I've got the normal Luna Grey felt on the back. And you're just going to put these up into each side, folded side of the ear. If you need to curve them off at all, just shape around them so you've not got any sharp bits that might stick out. So curved side out, flat side in to the fold, and just allow about 2 centimetres visibility sticking out of the bottom. I'm going to do my other side. Come on. So I've got those sticking out like that, and there's one I've done earlier, and this was my practice one, so everything's a bit all over the place. You can see one side's wider than the other, but you know, that's when I'm working on how to establish if something's going to work, I just tend to just chop and go. So you've got those in place, you're going to fold them over, and you're going to move on to the next stage. So I've got two there ready to go. And now I'm going to need my head. So before I started this, I got on the sewing machine. And this is where it really differs from how you would normally do it. So with the giant lunar pattern, we've given you seam allowance the whole way through. So you've got the option of using fabrics that you've got at home. It might be something like a calico. I wouldn't go as light as a bed sheet. You want something that once you've stuffed it, it's not going to show all the lumps and bumps of the stuffing. But so something with a little bit of weight to it. I wouldn't go any lighter than a quilting cotton probably to make it. And as I say, we've given you seam allowance so that you've got full flexibility. So here around the head, we've got 0.5 centimeter seam allowance on the outside and 2 centimeters on the ear angle. I've sewn from probably it looks like about 12 centimeters away from this edge, and I've done about 10 centimeters away from this edge with right sides together, if felt had a right side. And the reason I've done this is so that I can then insert the ears next. So I've marked my dots where my ear angle is going to be. I'm going to open up the head here so that I've got somewhere that I'm going to put the ears through. So obviously I need my Liberty facing outwards, otherwise the ears are going to be facing inwards. I'm looking for my felt edge rather than my plastic edge, and I'm pushing the ear in so that my felt is matching up and so that the ear just comes to the corner of that angle. You don't want it to go any further. You don't want to stretch it. It won't go any further unless you snipped it. But it's leaving us enough of a gap in the middle. So that one is in place. And I'm probably just going to take that pin out, to be honest. And you won't be able to pin, well, you won't be able to pin easily through the plastic, but you will be able to pin tight to the felt of the ear that's on that inside fold. So that's one in place. You might be able to pick up with a pin some of the felt as well there. So then I'm going in with the second one. I'm just threading it through and in. I'm looking for my felt edges to match. Now you can see that last time I've actually left my strip a little bit longer when I made it compared to the one that I've done this time. And your strips do still move, so you can always push them in and out. So if I had another pin, I would use another one. And what you're going to do now is you're going to put this through the sewing machine with a 2 centimeter difference away from the edge, 2 centimeter seam allowance, and go all the way across. And if you've got your dots matched, they will, you know, you'll go from the dot and come across here to the dot, and your machine will be fine going through this plastic and the layers. So I'm going to stop this now. I'm going to come back when I've done that to show you the next stage. So I'm back from being at the sewing machine, and I've taken my 2 centimeter seam allowance off here, and you can see when I turn it over and open it up that I've now got my ears as you wouldn't expect to normally see them in the head. Before we continue with the rest of the head seam, in order to make the ears stick up better, what I am going to do is I'm now going to snip into the corner of that angle, and that will allow everything to open up. So that's an important stage to move on. So you've done that on both sides. Okay, so when you've done that, you want to come to the outside and so I've got the front of the head there. And what I did was I'm looking to push the plastic back on itself. And that's the reason we've left extra length, is once this is stuffed, if that is pushed back, that will give us a little bit more stability. So what I'm trying to do now is I'm opening up the ear on the front, and I'm going to just, you can either use a sewing machine to do this or you can do it by hand, but I want to open up the base of the ear just by about a centimetre and a half and stitch it to the head felt so that it gives a wider base for the ear to be able to stand up. So you could either get this in your machine to do it, and if you don't want to involve the bottom plastic, move that out of the way and it might be easier for your machine. And just put a line of stitching just at the edge on either side, or just hand stitch the corners down about 1.5 centimetres wide, just to make it open out a little bit. Okay. So I've been to the machine and I have widened the base of the ear. If you imagine you were putting it through the machine, the ear will stick up in your way. So you almost want to kind of fold it down and out of the way to give yourself visibility to put it on the machine. But as I say, if you don't want to do that on the machine, you can definitely do it by hand. It's almost like doing a little bar tack, you know, just smoothing the felt out and giving some base to the ear so that it'll stand up. So once you've done that, and once you've done the other side as well, I'm using the Fiskars micro tip scissors, which I don't know whether some of you have got, but they're really useful for just for small projects and snipping stuff. So then I am turning everything through again to the wrong side, and this is where we finish the head off. So you will go back to the machine, and that's the back head. You'll just sew all the way round there, and then you'll come and do the same on the front head. So just with the front head, make sure that you've got a really smooth join. You don't want to have, you know, I would almost start before you finish there. So have a little bit of an overlap and just come down and get the front head sewn together. So come around here all the way to the neck. All right. And by the time you've done the front and the back, you know, you've got to kind of squeeze your ears in, make sure they're folded so that you can then turn through. Okay, I'm back from the sewing machine. What I did in the end was I did the front head first, and then I did the back head, finished stitching those. So if you haven't done it earlier on, now would be the point where you really should make sure that you are pressing your plastic open inside the ears before we turn it through, because that is going to be partially what supports the ear when it's standing up. So I've done that, and now I can, I'm not trimming anything off my seam allowance, because I think 0.5 centimetre is fine. I wasn't giving you any more than 0.5 centimetre, because then you would have just had to trim it off. And also it can kind of affect how the, you know, how the lines flow when you've stuffed it. So here we go. We have, pushing it through, we've got our ears. And then we've got Luna, and I have some stuffing to hand because I unpicked a giant Luna head this morning in order to to be able to reuse the ears. So I'm being very obviously, this is going to take an awful lot of stuffing. And if you don't have a lot of stuffing to hand, just buying some cheap pillows from a supermarket is a pretty efficient way. So as you're stuffing, you want to make sure that those bits of plastic have, you know, have stayed open and splayed, so that when you're putting the stuffing in, the stuffing is supporting that action. So they've not both moved to the back or anything. So just open them up if you think anything has changed. And stuff into that point that extends beyond the ear as well. When you're taking that 2 centimeter seam allowance out. So the reason I'm working on some fabric is because I thought my table was a bit dark. So this fabric is going to be sewn into a Tessuti Cora top. It's not on the website yet. We've had it in stock for a while, but the 10-year box was incredibly time consuming, and working on new website as well. And all the orders as well has meant we are super, the Grace and myself are super stretched at the moment. We are starting to think about Festival of Quilts, so I've been in the garage this morning sorting out what fabric I want to take, and thinking through what extra samples still need to be made. So there you can see roughly that Luna has a, can you see that she's got a slightly more sticky up ear? It's certainly not going to flop like if we hadn't have done the work that we've just done. It does need stuffing out more. And you can see here, this is exactly what I was talking about, where you overlap your stitching. That's where I've joined my stitching and it's not flowing. So you take your time and you do better than me with regards to doing that. I don't think I've got any more. Have I got more stuffing? I'm here to keep going with it. I do have a little bit more. Just push that in. So there really isn't anything else with regards to her body that I would do any differently. When we made the Community Luna for the workshop for the birthday weekend, the foot pad was too big. And I think the foot pad is probably on its limit on normal Luna. But as soon as we made it bigger and bigger, it just became bigger and bigger. So I've actually changed the dimensions of the foot pad with the enlargement. So if you're going to try and do this at home, you know, and magnify it yourself, I did it at 350%, then you might want to make your foot pad smaller like I have. So there we are. So I can't really show you that her ears are standing up, but I can promise you that they are standing up. And that's because we put the plastic inserts in, and because we also have done this kind of supportive stitching on the outside to give it a wider base. And if I pushed more stuffing into that, it will kind of sit smoother and better. So good luck, everybody. I can't wait to see them.